strong comedy background with films like Borat and Dirty Grandpa, but these have a pretty different energy than Home Sweet Home Alone, which is a, you know, family holiday film. So what made you want to work on a family film, and why Home Alone?
So, I think the fact that it has a very different energy was the thing that appealed to me, having sort of spent my life making filth and movies that my children cannot even see a single frame of, lest my wife find out and go crazy with them for sneaking down and looking, Googling Dan Mazer on the internet. I wanted to make something that perhaps they could watch and enjoy, first and foremost. And secondarily, and sort of tied into that, my youngest daughter, Minnie, is literally obsessed with Home Alone and had watched it, you know, 30 times. And it would be, shall we watch Jumanji today? No, Home Alone. Oh, okay, fair enough. Should we watch Aladdin today? No, Home Alone. Okay, you're having some friends over. Well, what do you want to watch? I mean, Home Alone. You're having a birthday party. What should we do? It's June. Nobody's watching Home Alone in June. It's a Christmas movie. But like, none of that seemed to, that she was just absolutely engrossed and obsessed with it. And so it seemed almost cruel of me to turn down the opportunity if it was offered. So I think finally she can be proud of her dad, or at least if not proud, then actually, you know, mention what he does.
That's fair. Has she gotten to see the movie yet?
You know what? She hasn't yet. And I'm sort of saving it for like a big gala thing this weekend where we're all going to sit down and do it together when I fly back to London. And actually, she's the one person I'm incredibly nervous of. And she's seen like little bits and pieces, because during COVID, I had to edit from home quite a lot and do that remotely. And she'd come in and she'd sit there and she'd, you know, look it over very seriously, and I'd be like, is that good? And she'd be like, well, I'm not sure about that, but you're doing that bit. And so when I got a laugh from her, or just like, oh, that's funny from her, that was like, okay, all right, it can go in, we're done, that's good. So yeah, she's the person I'm most nervous of seeing it.
That's fair. Children are the harshest critics.
Oh, it's unbearable. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So obviously this wouldn't be a Home Alone movie without all of the pranks and the injury comedy. So which of Max's pranks were the most difficult to shoot?
Wow. So it was a thing where I was very intent on using as little CGI as possible, because I wanted to, you know, to keep it real and have the actors reacting to real things and see the real genuine fear in their eyes as they feared for their lives, as things kind of propelled towards them. So in terms of difficulty, like, we had an amazing stunt team from New Zealand who made everything that seemed incredibly complicated and difficult actually relatively, you know, safe and simple, which is obviously crucial. But in terms of, you know, sort of the reality of, there's a sequence where Ellie is, as Pam, is bombarded by Mentos infused Pepsi bottles, which that was pretty difficult, kind of, you know, thrusting Pepsi at her for days on end, and then dousing her in kind of Pepsi foam and things like that. That seemed a little bit unfair. And then there's another moment where Rob jumps into a shelf and is sort of pummeled by objects. And again, in my sort of cruelty, I wanted to make sure that the objects were A, real, and B, sort of as heavy as kind of permissible in order to, you know, elicit the proper reaction for him. So he was kind of pelted in the groin by vases for what seemed like an inordinately long time. But they were very willing and sporting about it.
I'm sure it seemed like a very long time for him.
Frankly, any time to be pummeled in the groin is too long, right?
Yeah, that's fair. A little easier from behind the camera, just watching it.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah, which is the sort of the key to my life professionally, which is I spend my time getting people to do things that I would absolutely never in a million years do, whether it's kind of Sasha as Borat when we go out and, you know, kind of go to a white supremacist rally and get him to goad them as much as possible as I stand behind the camera making him go further, or whether it's sort of, you know, pummeling Rob Delaney in the groin. It's slightly... Now I think about it, it says many things about me.
I do see the parallels. It makes sense.
Yeah, exactly. Just sadism.
Now, since you are behind the camera, you're not having to deal with the pranks, but in a hypothetical world where you would be forced to endure all of Max's pranks except for one, what's the one that you would not want to have to deal with? Which one is too far? I can't handle that.
Oh, I think probably the pins in the face from the Nerf gun would be one that I was relatively keen to avoid, I think. And the, you know, and the fact that in the, our version of it, they avoid the eyes is good. But ultimately that one looked pretty painful and sort of not even with any kind of fun attached to it. Whereas, you know, jumping off a balcony or whatever, you know, some of the other things seem like they might actually be fun and there might be some element of kind of adrenaline about them. But bombarded by Nerf pins in the face, not so good.
Yeah, not great. I haven't been thinking about the potential of them getting in your eyes. That might change my answer, because originally I was going with the pool bottle forehead.
Oh, yeah. It
seems very painful, but it's true. I do not want pins in my eyes, so.
Yeah, the pool ball to the forehead is the one that elicits the most oohs in an audience, because that just, yeah, that seems yeah, unduly harsh, doesn't it? Yeah, true.
So obviously, Home Sweet Home Alone revolves around a family forgetting their son at home. So I'm wondering, what is the most important thing you've accidentally left behind when you went to go travel somewhere?
Oh, my dignity probably is the thing that I've left behind on many occasions when I've gone on various sort of, you know, kind of bachelor parties, that sort of thing. That's been left behind quite a lot. What else have I left behind? I mean, just boring things like passports. I've left behind twice, and that's annoying, especially when
my
family all went off without me and just said, well, we're not waiting for you. So then I had to sort of go out and come out later and miss. It actually worked out very well. It's quite a good hint, because you miss all the sort of boring stuff of having to kind of, you know, take your family, check into a hotel, sort out the room, sort out all the boring logistics. So actually maybe forget your passport, get them to go ahead, do all the boring stuff, and then you can have a lovely relaxing journey, reading, and everything's ready for you when you arrive. So that's
fair. Hey.
Yeah. Yeah, good life.
That's quite a good plan.
Yeah, yeah, I like it.
All right, what do you want people to walk away from Home Sweet Home Alone with this holiday season?
So I think we've had a pretty rough 18 months as a human race. And during that time, I think we've come to realize that the value of the things that actually the film is about, which is family and our homes and taking care of each other and supporting each other and protecting each other. And so what I would love is just the families to spend 90 minutes sitting down, watching this, escaping, laughing, realizing, if they don't already realize it, which I'm sure they do, just how important our homes and our families are above and beyond everything else. But ultimately it's kind of 90 minutes of escapism from all the annoyance and rubbish that's been surrounding us for 18 months and just enjoying Christmas as a time for family with family.
Absolutely. And then final and most important question, will Max be left home alone again? Is there going to be a sequel?
It's an excellent and very important question. And I mean, let's see how this one goes, but let's hope so. Let's hope so.
Sounds good. I'd be down to see him pull some more crazy pranks.
Oh, fantastic. Well, from your lips to God's ears, as my mother would say.
Absolutely. Yeah. All right, that's my time for today.
That out again, haven't we? So that's the most important thing. That seems like a reason to do it. Brilliant. Thank you so much. Really, really nice to meet you. Thank you for
everything. Yeah, thank you. Happy holidays early.
Happy holidays. Exactly.
I hope your daughter enjoys the film.
Thank you.